Okay, so here we are in our editor, and we've got our form handling code, and right now it just prints thanks every time. Let's actually use our new verification functions. So I've added a line here. I'm calling the valid month function that we just wrote, and I'm sending in as the first argument to that function the month parameter that was included in our request. And so this will indicate whether our response was valid or not. And I'm going to go ahead and add this for the day and the year as well. Okay, so we've got these three variables, and now let's actually check them. If not user month and user day and user year, we're going to re-render the form again. If all three of these aren't true, we're going to render our form. Else, if they are all true, we're going to say thanks, which we have down here. So to recap, we're getting our three parameters from the request. We're running them through our valid month, day, and year functions. And if they are not all true, we rewrite the form. And if they are all true, we say thanks. That's a totally valid day. All right, let's give this a shot in our browser. Okay, so here we are in our browser. I'm going to type in a day again. Okay, so I've typed in what I think is a valid month, day, and year. And when I hit submit, our browser says thanks. That's a totally valid day. And let's go to the form again. And this time we're going to type in something invalid. Okay, now I've got an invalid month and, you know, normal day and year. And when I click submit, the form just clears because we sent back the form again. We can improve this a little bit, and let's start doing that now.